when I talk my
come on
that other side
the Oakland way.
Hey,
C5.
Can't nobody do me like I do me. And I don't care to be nobody else because I'm unique. I'm fine with me. I am God and God is me.
We are situated about 8 miles west of New York City at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford.
First off, my name Toe, but it's really Tobe Chukwu. Got a BM that keep my season, that keep me fufu. Grew up wearing platinum fubu on the Southwest eating fufu. And a hammer that I keep don't come with nails. Look, I ain't know who Bill Burr was until I met the man. Half my married to the street without a wedding band. I done peeped at all these rappers won't be secondhand. My pop said I'd be broke and barely eat. I should have bet the man. Yeah, cause I'm way, way, way up. Long ways from the days I deva valet stores. Couldn't pay nowadays. All the cake I make us is enough to buy about 100 trucks from Mercedes. I resage Chukwu with it. Then my babies. Label hippie trying to sway me. Sway me, pay me. Wrote the game 2020. You can see it plainly. Can't nobody play me. I kill everything innately. At the helm of the mothership of drip. You can see me leaking. Be quiet, a real speaking voice of God. Every word I jot, feel the spirit breathing. That's new artist, but the way I cook, very seasoned. Everything around me moving, like bachata. Usher told me do it my way, Frank Sinatra. Been a shot to been locked in with my katas now.
From the stadium that hosted Super Bowl 48 back in 2014, there's a look at MetLife Stadium here in East Rutherford. Tonight, it's our first Monday night game of the new season, and we've got a good one coming up, as it'll be the Buffalo Bills taking on the New York Jets. The new era begins here at MetLife Stadium. The Bills and Jets underway to close out week one. And no run back on this one, so the new season will begin at the 25-yard line. Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Second down. Shot here for Hardman. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete. So Aaron Rodgers here getting his first run in a Jets uniform. Well, he'll get 3 of his first 4 games at home, but it is an intimidating slate. You got Buffalo tonight. They go to Dallas next Sunday, followed by a divisional home game against the Patriots, a team that's had their number, to put it mildly. And then the Super Bowl champs come in week 4.
And don't forget, not far behind them, the Eagles in week 6. But I think that this is a great way to open for Aaron Rodgers. If you've ever wanted a challenge, this is it.
And the Bills are going to get him. as he goes down. It was Vaughn Miller who shot in there to get him down.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. They call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at the 45. Throwing to start the drive. Allen. And that is going to be incomplete as he let him a bit too much.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
Here's second and 10.
Alert, alert, alert!
Allen gonna throw. Little pitch and catch to the tight end, Knox. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slows momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. Deep for Diggs. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. It's Chuck Clark picking it off. And the Jets are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 24-yard line.
Okay, partner, no surprise to you. I'm going to look at this from the defensive perspective. In the rain, you have to be more cautious trying to cover passing routes. Why? The offense knows where they're going with the football. The receiver knows the route he's going to run. You have to make sure you keep your footing underneath you.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And one of the things we like to hit on every year are the new rule changes. So we got a few for 2023. A lot are procedural, having to do with deadlines and roster construction and such. But the two kind of caught my eye, Charles. One is the option to fair catch a kickoff and have it come out to the 25 like it does in college. You like that?
I don't. I don't like it at all. I don't like it in college. I don't like it in the NFL. I want to have something different. And I really wanted the special teams coaches to be a little bit more involved. But I do understand why the league is doing it. They believe it promotes safety, and it's hard to argue against that.
What about, this is the other one, guys can now wear the number zero. We've already seen some. There he goes on the side! And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first. On that last run, he's now hit the 6,000-yard mark for rushing yards in his career.
And moves him squarely into the top 100 rushers of all time. In fact, he can boast that he's rushed for over 1,000 yards more than Gale Sayers did in his career. And Gale Sayers was a Hall of Famer in a short career.
Following the good run by Cook, here's another first and 10. Hands it off out of the gun. Nice his way forward here, but just 3 yards on the play. Second down.
That's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
from the 47 now to work with a second and seven. Well, everybody was up there ready at the line of scrimmage, CD, but no snap, and the delay of game ensued.
Yeah, and I'm sure their head coach is asking the exact same thing. What's going on out there? Almost like they thought they had more time than actually was on the clock.
Now they'll throw with Rodgers. Out to the right here to Wilson. And down he goes at the 49, a three-yard pickup. Come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills 39. And they get 10 yards there and convert on third. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Rodgers directing traffic, going to change the play. First down, here's the run with Cook. Yeah, he tries to keep the legs churning, but he's going to be stopped behind the line.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Throwing is Rodgers. Able to complete this one to Tyler Conklin. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. And they take him down. The Bills get to him. That's Matt Milano firing in from his linebacker position. Here's Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on fourth down. Just a 30-yard punt that time. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week one. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I actually like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First of all, it allows you to see that in the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet when you do have injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people.
And I think the ball's out, and it's scooped up by the Jets. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. And they put it on the ground here on the second drive. And, of course, Charles, that follows drive number one where they had the INT.
Makes you wonder what's going on with this team, because a lot of times we can attribute it to nerves, but maybe it's a lack of focus. Maybe it's the preparation for the game. Maybe they just came into it more lackadaisical, because that's just not looking good at all. That's just not the football that we came here to see.
No score after one on EA Sports. So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard. Now Cook running right. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. 51 yards rushing for him in his first half as he is looking in mid-season form here in the opener. A chance for their first points of the season here as it's first and goal. In motion right, that's Hardman. Oh, a fake on the jet sweep as they run with Cook up the middle. And he gets him a little bit closer, takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
Go to 50. Hey, you block over here. Go to 50. Hey, take 26.
Rodgers now to throw. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
They may be snapping the ball near the goal line, but all you're thinking defensively, keep them out of the end zone. Force the incompletion, force them into going for 3 and not giving up 6.
A big play, if you think about it, right now in this season opener. It's 3rd and goal. Cook. Runs up, fighting his way in for a Jets touchdown. Dalvin Cook taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Jets post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. A good hold in these wet conditions. The point after is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. Taken at the goal line. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. 2 drives, 2 turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath. First, do no harm. And right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis.
Well, I think after that run, the defense is getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards. And now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them? And do I have enough confidence to make a play?
On second down, right back to Hines. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up the 3rd down. Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage, because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, if it was to bring in your tight end, keep him in, your running backs, they have to step forward. Bottom line, your offensive line has to block them first to give yourself a chance.
Now a 3rd down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. Fourth down, here's Sam Martin on to kick it away. Back deep for the Jets, McCole Hardman. And it's fielded at the 34. The 41-yard punt, 9 on the return.
And the Jets will take over.
The New York offense taking over for their next possession. Things progressing to plan so far. Their defense has been solid, and they've got themselves a 7-0 lead after the touchdown the last time they had the ball.
And this is no time to even think about, hey, are we going to milk the clock? Hey, are we just going to do ball control? This is the NFL. 7-0 leads, they don't last very long unless you continue to push the envelope on offense. I know it was a game, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay game.
Now the offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. Motion man left is Lazard. On second down, here's Rodgers. Setting up the screen for Cook. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Now, hang on, we've got an injured player down there. And, oh my, oh, that's Aaron Rodgers, the quarterback shaken up.
Boy, you always hate to see injuries, especially tough here in week one. Just hoping this is nothing serious. We'll take a quick timeout. They'll try the middle with Cook. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 67 yards for him on the ground so far tonight, as he has been terrific in this first half.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. A 10th carry in the game for Cook. And after the good gain last play, this time they say, uh-uh, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
But they're certainly not neglecting their run duties as well, as they ate up the blockers in front and allowed the secondary to get home.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Wilson wants a different look. Now the second year man back from injury. It's Breece Hall. And he will finally be tracked down at the Bills 9. All told, it's an even 30 and a first down.
Not too shabby for his first carry of the game. That's exactly what most teams are looking for. A really good change of pace back.
They'll run with Cook. And this play goes nowhere, losing yardage back to the 15.
He's already found the end zone once in this half, and they do a nice job there pushing him backwards and denied his bid for a second score.
First down, a bit of a disaster, and now on second and goal, back even further. First throw for the backup, Wilson. And he takes a shot on the release, as this will be incomplete.
I think think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. From the gun, it's Wilson. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Cook. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
I know we saw the pass and the completion and obviously the resulting loss of yardage. To me, that play broke down with the blocking on it, because if you're going to try and swing it that far outside, that blocking's got to hold up to give your guy a chance.
And the defense, they weren't fooled at all.
No, not at all. They were aggressive on that one.
So that one on target, and it adds to this first half lead.
And maybe we're too early to worry too much about one-score lead, two-score lead, etc., but this is where you kind of start banking those points that come in helpful later on.
Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And this is not an easy situation. You're down early, in the elements, you're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness. Maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
Now Allen throwing on second down. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. Here's Allen. Eluding the pressure right. And they're able to get this one across the 35. First down now, but that clock rolling. Now it's Hines, and he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. The Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. Here's Allen to throw it. Got a man, that's Trent Sherfield. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. First down now, but the clock continues to move. To the air, Allen. He's got this one complete to Sherfield. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And he returns this to the 22.
The Bills take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive. Now the new pickup from New England. This is Damian Harris. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
Well, it's tough time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Here now, second and nine from the 39-yard line. Throwing now is Allen. That's caught by Gabriel Davis. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first.
Well, that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
From midfield, here's Allen. Quick hitter here, it's complete. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
But look what we have here, a sustained drive, and that was certainly AWOL in the first half. They really struggled to try and move the football. But right now, they certainly seem to have the formula working. Let's see if they can keep it up.
Give to Cook out of the gun. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Now a second and six. They run it again with Cook. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. It's a gain of 13 and a Buffalo first down.
Partner, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get him. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for him. Show him that you're supposed to get the football.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Harris running straight ahead. The linebacker C.J. Mosley in on the stop.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
And they'll come up second and seven.
Getting the ball is Cook running left. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety, being able to hit people with a run in the pass. But in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU, most valuable unit, but you're right. It might go to them in this game.
I like that. MVU. Well done.
They'll break the huddle and come up on the ninth play of this drive, needing 5 yards on third down. To throw, it's Allen. And it's intercepted at the goal line. It's Chuck Clark picking it off. And the Jets force the turnover. They'll take over at the 10. Well, field goals probably aren't going to cut it at this point. This was touchdown or bust, and unfortunately for them, it turned out to be bust.
Yeah, they're feeling like they've got to force the issue here, maybe take some chances they wouldn't have earlier in the game. But give credit to this defense. They've really stood tall throughout, and they come up with the interception in the end zone.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. They'll start on the ground. Hall. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Not a huge play, but I think they're more than happy with how it turned out. Don't be surprised to see them revisit that call, because there was a lane there for more than just 5 yards. Put in your back pocket and break it out when you need it later.
Now second and five.
Kelly, don't let Kelly.
Back to the ground, this time Cook. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. 72 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game.
They run again on first down, Cook. Now he's loose at the 40. And finally down at the 32-yard line. A big hitter. That one goes for 40 yards. Once he broke through that first wave of defenders, there was a pretty big gap there for him to run.
And it helps that they were in a dime defense. That's six defensive backs. So this is why a lot of teams now are searching for those linebacker-safety combo-type guys who can add a little bit more size on the defensive side of the ball, but can still run as well. Because when you run against six DBs with some bigger offensive linemen, you often get this result.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. Catch is made by Hardman. And they move this all the way down to the 9. A little over 20 yards there, and in two plays, they now move the ball over 60 yards.
How about the way they're moving the ball down the field? They had a big play a moment ago, followed it up with another nice one here, and before you know it, they're already looking at first and goal.
They'll run with Hall. And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line.
And now defensively, you have to look at this like the game's on the line. It's just a third quarter, but another touchdown given up here could really spell an end to their chances. So they need to toughen up and keep them out of the end zone.
Jumbo!
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. A line of scrimmage, once again the 5, as they get ready for second and goal. One more time with Hall. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the 1. So now things get interesting on third and goal from the 1.
This almost becomes a Darwinian call, doesn't it? Almost survival of the fittest here. I know we can go all cliche. I'll go ahead and do it.
And he is in. Touchdown, New York. Breece Hall taking it in from a yard out. And the Jets are closing in on a winning start to the year as they extend their fourth quarter lead. Zuerlein good with a PAT. And that makes our score 17-0. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21.
The Bills take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And they knew coming in that this would be a tough place to go in and win a season opener. But this has just been a performance, and to be frank, not to be proud of here as they trail big in this fourth quarter. A good pickup there, 21 yards. A three-score game here late. You can probably rule out the comeback, but certainly some kind of a moral victory to be had if they can get a few more points to close things out. And to that end, a nice pass play there to push things downfield.
Yeah, and we know in this league, a loss is a loss, and no one wants anything to count as a moral victory or, boy, something that feels a little bit cheap. But they trim that lead down to just 2 scores, that's still a benefit to this squad.
Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
It hasn't been the cleanest game for him, but there was a sign of improvement as he looks towards the next one. Nice bit of scrambling to move the sticks, and even more importantly, he didn't risk adding another interception to his ledger.
On first down, Allen. Sideline, it's complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 17 yards on the play as they try to eat into this 17-point deficit. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. They'll give to Cook on the read option. They stopped after only a yard, taking it down to the 14. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
Finding Knox there, complete. And the Bills are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line. First and goal. Cook will take this over the line. Touchdown, Buffalo. So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still 2 scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you'd kept them out of the end zone there, this game's over. You've locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Now, there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs to keep up with your theme there, playing keep away.
Oh, and a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch. Big yardage that time for the Jets. 48 yards.
And this is seemingly how it's been all game long. This defense has been just a step too slow. And here they're burned again. Another big play.
Go to 50. Hey, you block over here.
Hey, Mike. Now Rodgers going to shift him around. That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit. So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now. First and 15 following the delay of game.
Hey, 26.
Rodgers going to throw. Pass complete. He's got Lazard on the out route. So 5 yards here, five on the play, and it's second down.
I'll go over here.
Cook up the gut. And just good downhill running there as he'll take this to the 15-yard line. 124 yards rushing for him now here in week one. A very solid start to this new campaign. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. On first and 10, it's Hall. And they'll get to him just inside the 15, even after that strong run we witnessed. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. And this defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in. And all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up.
Got him, and it's caught. Touchdown, Jets. Tyler Conklin from 13 yards out. And the Jets are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead.
I think all teams probably like seeing that schedule for the first time, looking at week one. Oh, good. We're at home. This is why you want to be home in week one. They're looking sharp.
And I agree with you totally. That's what you want. But there carries a little extra pressure with that as well, because you and I both know protecting the home field, winning your home games is paramount in this league. So you go into it, yeah, we want it, but now you actually have to go out and prove it.
Yeah, two sides to that coin, and looking like they're going to protect it here in this one.
And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. And no doubt this is not the way that they had hoped to open their season. Thoroughly outplayed here in front of the national audience. This will be a gain of about 8 to the 27-yard line.
I think the defense surprised him there with that blitz on first down, but give him credit. Stayed cool under pressure and still found a way through the extra rushers for positive yardage. Well done.
Allen. He's got the hookup with Diggs. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now Allen. He'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack. Now they got to get to the line quickly. On play action, Allen. And Allen going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked off by Bryce Hall. And the Jets are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield.
For this defense, CeeDee, that's kind of the icing on the cake here as we get to the end of this one.
And didn't you feel that they weren't just going into total prevent there? You know, they had the lead, and sometimes you fall back and you lose your aggressiveness. Not in this case. They were still making a play on the football, and look how that one turned out. They may have salted this one away.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And this is really the start to the season that you're hoping for if you're a coach or a player. They've got the big lead here in the fourth quarter and now can really take some time off the clock. Daquan Jones in on the tackle there. Second and 6. Hall again on second down.
Call it a gain of five there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
They need two. Here's third down. They'll run with Hall. On a nice burst there as he'll take his inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Jet first down.
Sit down.
Hall again. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Week one primetime games, they always seem to have a little bit more.
I can get it gone in the blink. We can make a